Hi everyone, I'm Wayne McDonald. I'm going to be sharing with you today keys that will guarantee that you will live an abundant life and have great success right here today on the broadcast. Hi everybody, thanks so much for joining me. I'm Wayne McDonald, you're listening to Living an Abundant Life, and I want to share with you today some keys that will enhance your life and that will cause you to live an abundant life. Jesus said in John chapter 10 and verse number 10, "The thief comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I have come so that you might have and enjoy life and have it in abundance to the full, till it overflows." And that's what I want to talk to you about, having and enjoying life in abundance to the full till it overflows. If you want to enjoy life in abundance to the full till it overflows and have it in abundance, well, you have to connect with the giver of life. In him is life, and it says he is the life and the light of men. So in order to have abundant life, you have to just go back to basics, connecting with the giver of life, reading the word, putting him first place, studying his word, seeking his face, putting him first. You know, whatever you do with the first 10 to 15 minutes of your day, it sets the course for the rest of your day. If you get up first thing in the morning and go right to the Word of God and start to read the Word of God and listen to the voice of your Heavenly Father without any interruptions, without any other distractions, you are setting the course for things to go well for you. You are setting the course to have and enjoy life in abundance, to the full, till it overflows. So if you don't have that as a daily habit, I want you to write down on a piece of paper. I want you to set time aside that you will read the Word and that you will focus on listening to the voice of your Heavenly Father, reading the Word and then quieting yourself and listening to that still small voice that speaks ever so softly within your heart, and begin to discern His voice. You can discern His voice, but it takes pushing everything back. And I've made it a habit for the last over 20 some years of doing this, putting His Word first place and going to His Word first thing in the morning, because I know as the day gets moving, I probably won't get back there. I probably won't open up the Word of God again, because things start happening, life starts happening. There's so many things pulling on us. So I put Him first place in the morning. And the Bible says in the book of Matthew, chapter number 6 and verse 33, "But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, His way of doing things, and everything you need," I'm paraphrasing it, "shall be added unto you." As you seek Him first, how do you put Him first? By reading His Word first thing in the morning. Instead of going to Facebook or checking the email or sitting down and reading the morning paper first or checking the news, check out what the Father has to say to you and meditate on it. Get it in you. Focus reading. Focus listening without any distractions. I've done this for over 20 some years of my life, and it's caused things to go well for me. I'm not saying that I don't ever have a bad day. I'm not saying that I don't have conflict. I don't have things to deal with like you do in every one of our lives. Life happens. But this is a sure anchor for my soul, no matter what is going on in my life. Good things, bad things, in between things. This is an anchor, and it will do the same for you. You can have and enjoy life in abundance to the full till it overflows. But it takes getting connected first thing in the morning. Set the course of your day by spending time in the Word and by listening to the voice of your Heavenly Father. And if you'll do that, you will have and enjoy life in abundance to the full till it overflows. The second thing is keeping the body strong. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So it's our responsibility to exercise. It's our responsibility to take good care by what we eat and by what we think, conditioning the brain, conditioning the body. Having and enjoying life in abundance to the full, till it overflows, is about exercising the body, thinking right, and eating right. You can have and enjoy life, and you can have it in abundance to the full, till it overflows. The next thing, when you have that established, that you are reading the Word and you're listening to the voice of your Father, the most important thing that you can possibly do next is exercise. Why? When you exercise, there's all kinds of endorphins that are released in the brain. Dopamine, serotonin, those feel-good chemicals are released in abundance, along with a host of other chemicals that are neurologically released and cause us to feel good. So if you struggle with feeling bad, you feel depressed, get up and spend time in the Word, meditating on what the Father is saying, that He loves you and that He has a plan and a purpose for your life. And then go exercise. Get those endorphins released. Get them flowing. If you'll do that, you will have and enjoy life in abundance to the full, till it overflows. You'll feel so much better about you, and you'll be able to emanate that joy, emanate that peace that comes as you spend time with your Heavenly Father, listening to His voice, in His Word, and then you're exercising, you're conditioning your body. You know, if we don't take good care of these bodies, they can become a burden to us and a burden to our family members. So I'm telling you about these keys and the way I've lived for all these years, over 20 some years, I've been putting these into practice. So I have authority to speak them into your life. And I realize that a lot of things are not taught, they're caught. But I have the authority to impart these things so you can catch them, because this is the way I live. This just isn't something I thought it was a good idea. This is the essence and the heart of my life's message right here. Spending time with the Lord first thing in the morning, connecting with the giver of life. And then second of all, exercising so that we are presenting our best to the Father. We're saying, I'm giving you this body, I'm giving you this mind, I'm giving you this whole system that's so intricate and so majestically, marvelously made, this body. I'm presenting it back to you. I'm going to be a good steward over what you have entrusted me. And then the third thing that I focus on, and I'm giving you them in the level of priority, this is the way I prioritize my day. Number one, spending time with the Lord. Number two, exercising and then eating real well. I had a good breakfast this morning. And as I'm ministering this to you and sharing this with you, this is what I'm doing as I'm going through my morning. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning where I'm recording this here in New Jersey. And this is the way I've lived my life for over 20 some years, and today is no different. I'm going through these keys in the level, in the realm of priority. I'm prioritizing my day, putting Him first, then exercise, then connecting with my family, connecting with my daughter, connecting with my wife, by sitting with them, by talking with them, by hugging them, by ministering to them, asking them about their day, making plans, spending time with them today. Focused effort. You know, good marriages don't just happen. Even if you feel like you've married your soulmate, sometimes people get distraught. They say, you know, I thought I married the right person, but things aren't going good. I don't feel like I love him. I don't feel like I love her. You have to put effort. You have to put work into the relationship, even if you feel like you've married your soulmate. If you are in the same stride, the same rhythm, you have the same beliefs, you're serving the King, you're in the kingdom of God, your heart is born again because you've said yes to Jesus and to the power of His blood. It's been applied to your life. Your heart's been regenerated. Even if you both are on the same page, you're both born again. Maybe you're filled with the Holy Spirit. You're seeking Him together. Maybe you're going to church together. It still takes work. It still takes you putting out energy, reading books on marriage, listening to other people who have a successful marriage, putting effort out to have a date night, to have family night. These are things that I've had in place for years, and I continue to fight for these things because life happens to try to pull you off course, to try to get you distracted. And when we do get off course and get distracted, we get right back on as soon as we possibly can, because we know that there is abundant life that's produced as we spend time together. We strengthen our marriage, we strengthen our family unit by having family night and go and have fun together. My wife and I set dates up regularly where we go on dates, just myself and just her. Sometimes we'll go with other friends of ours and just go and have fun. That's why you married that person, because you were, of course, attracted to them, but you enjoy their presence. You want to have fun. And there's nothing greater that bonds a couple together. Number one, having sex bonds you together. There are all kinds of chemicals that are being released, bonding chemicals. And you do it not because you just feel sexual, but because it's the right thing to do. You bond together. And then number two, spending time together, having fun. That bonds you together. Fight for your marriage. Fight for your home. Prioritizing the King first, His Word first. You get your spiritual life on point first, then get you on point by that body being fed the right foods, by strengthening the body, and keeps the mind clear, keeps the brain clear, keeps everything functioning properly. And number three, you fight for your family. Fight for time with your husband. Fight for time with your wife. Fight. Write down an action plan. Set date nights up. Put it on the calendar. Get out your calendar today. Get someone to watch the kids. Write it down. Talk to your spouse about it. It's a time to work things out. Work out issues. Life happens and there's issues that come up. And what happens is, if we don't talk through these issues and spend time together, it becomes volcanic. And all of a sudden you're going to explode on the other person. How can I tell you that? Because I used to be that way. I used to just hold all my emotions in and never say anything, and then blow up and start screaming. That's not the perfect way to do it. You're still always going to have conflict in marriage because you're joining two separate people, two different ways, two different rhythms of doing things together. You're going to have conflict, but in a healthy marriage, you're going to work through those conflicts. You're going to talk things out. You're going to get on the same page, and you don't have to do it by screaming. The Bible says a gentle word disarms wrath. It turns away wrath. So you can communicate with a lower voice tone and healthily, and that marriage unit will be healthy. So I'm sharing with you keys that will cause you to have and enjoy life in abundance to the full till it overflows. Key number one, spending time with the Lord. Fight for your time with the Lord. Number two, fight to exercise. Go for a walk, a jog, lift weights in the gym, focus on your diet. If you need help, I'm here to serve you. In 2015, I decided to become a certified fitness trainer so that I could help more people. I've been educating myself for over 20 some years in this area. Every week I'm reading articles and watching videos from acclaimed doctors and nutritionists, reading their books, listening to their broadcasts, and educating myself so that I know what foods to put in and what foods not to put in. So this body, I only have one body, and I want to live my entire life healthy and strong all the days of my life, even to way, way up in age. I believe we can have a clear mind, a strong, healthy body, but there is some things that we need to do. We need to be responsible. And number three, fighting for my family. I'm constantly listening to people who are experts in this area, who teach these principles of marriage. And I read the books, and I constantly focus on this area, constantly communicating with my wife, asking her, is everything all right? Is everything okay with us? We have what we call communication book, where we write down things that are maybe hot topics, and we communicate through that communication book, and we deal with issues as they come up and move forward, and you can do the same. And then number four, after those three are in place, if you can just get these three in place, your time with the Lord, your exercise and focus it on your nutrition, and get on the same page with your spouse, you can pretty much conquer the world. You can pretty much do anything if you can just get in agreement with those three areas. Then number four, once those three things are in place and they're operating the way they should be, then number four, now I'm free to, first of all, discover my purpose, but then fulfill my God-given purpose. What are you passionate about? What have you been wired to do? What is that thing that keeps coming up on the inside of you and you're drawn to it as far as your vocation? You're going to give time, effort, energy, money to this specific area, and it's going to generate finances for you, but it's not going to just generate finances for you. It's going to generate joy. You're going to be thrilled in throwing yourself into something that will benefit and add value to other people. You can always discover and know what your God-given purpose is, because it will not go away over time. The vocation that He has for you, it has to do with you using your gifts, your talents, your abilities. It's the things that just, they come natural to you. Now, I'm not saying when they do come natural to you that you don't need to spend time developing them. You do, but it's just natural. When I speak, it feels as natural as can be. When I teach music, it feels absolutely natural. If I'm helping someone with nutrition, with exercise, it's absolutely natural. Well, the purpose of God is in those things. That's His purpose and plan for my life. I don't know what God has specifically for you, but if you'll ask Him, He will speak to your heart and He will reveal to you His plan and purpose for your life. We're out of time today, but I thank you so much for tuning in. I'm teaching out of my book, 7 Keys to Living an Abundant Life. You can get a copy of this over at www.voicetothenations.com. I encourage you to get a copy of this for yourself and for your kids and for your kids' kids. This will change generations. This will affect your family tree. This deals with some of the principles that I've been dealing with today in great detail, and it goes into even greater depth than I have the time to teach you with today. But I encourage you, get a copy of this. It also helps Laura and I continue to go out and travel. It helps us to continue to have the time and the resources to be able to develop more books and to develop more broadcasts so that we can minister to you, so we can strengthen you in your marriage, we can strengthen you in your relationship with your Heavenly Father, we can help you in the area of exercise and nutrition, help you discover your purpose. That's why this exists. You can also download this. You don't have to even wait and go on the website and have us ship it out to you. You can go to Amazon.com, put in 7 Keys to Living an Abundant Life, Wayne McDonald, it'll come right up, and you can download this immediately on your tablet, on your mobile device. I encourage you to go through it over and over again. It's interactive. There's videos at the end of each chapter where you can go and listen to the information that was taught in the book, and I'll be reiterating that on a video at the end of each chapter. So I encourage you to get a copy of this. It's going to continue to strengthen our voice, and together we are a voice to the nations. You can also follow us on Facebook at Voice to the Nations Worldwide Evangelism. You can follow us on Twitter at Wayne McDonald. Go to the website, voicetothenations.com. We love to strengthen you and help you grow and fulfill the things that your Heavenly Father has for you. Well, thanks so much for tuning into this broadcast. Have a great week. Share it with someone. It can change their life forever. God bless you.